After 11 days of massive protests, brutal repression, and a general upheaval in Ecuador, the government of President Moreno and the most important indigenous organizations agreed to engage in negotiations to discuss the cancellation of austerity measures that President Moreno had imposed about 2 weeks ago following the IMF prescriptions. The economic measures included a near doubling of fuel prices, about 23,000 layoffs in the public sector, and the deregulation of labor laws following a neoliberal model. As soon as the measures were announced, protesters came walking and in caravans from different regions of Ecuador. They started to arrive at Quito on Saturday, October 5th, and continued arriving for over 11 days. They marched to demand the cancellation of the IMF decree that would directly affect the poorest. One of the main organizations behind the protest and the strike was CONAIE, the Confederation of Indigenous Nations of Ecuador.
Nos hemos convocado todo el pueblo ecuatoriano, está la CONAIE, estamos todos los colectivos haciendo presencia y exigiendo que se derogue el decreto 883. Nosotros como pueblos indígenas siempre nos hemos mantenido en resistencia más de 530 años y nosotros no somos saboteadores, no somos como nos están tipificando los otros medios de comunicación. Nosotros somos un pueblo que lucha con la cara de frente exigiendo que se cumpla estos derechos. Y también cabe mencionar que le hemos manifestado, si mientras no se derogue el decreto 883, no nos vamos a movilizar de este espacio que nos hemos posesionado.
Ever since the indigenous movements announced that they would be marching to the cities, the government began militarizing the capital. The indigenous rally managed to enter Quito nonetheless, but security forces systematically attacked and repressed them. Their massive presence in the city aroused racist reactions from right-wing and xenophobic urban groups, something that Ecuador's indigenous peoples clearly reject.
Que se vayan al campo a trabajar, a ver si pueden un día resistir una larga labor de trabajo, arando las tierras, sembrando las chacras, cosechando lo que ustedes solamente van al supermercado a comprar con su dinero lo que el pueblo ha trabajado. Sin el pueblo, la ciudad no es nada. Y es así que hasta ahora hemos venido luchando y nosotros no nos cansaremos, a pesar de que a nosotros nos dicen ociosos, vayan a trabajar. Nosotros ya hemos, para nosotros eso es normal. Nosotros hemos venido y aún así seguimos hablando nuestro idioma, aún así seguimos con nuestra vestimenta y seguiremos luchando por este paquetazo que nos afecta a todos los ciudadanos ecuatorianos.
Although race conflicts are structural in Ecuadorian society, not everyone rejects the indigenous population. Hundreds of volunteers in the capital organized an enormous solidarity operation, collecting supplies such as medicines, blankets, and food for the thousands of indigenous people who came to spend several nights in the city. For over 11 days, they have been cooking, serving, and helping the indigenous communities in a struggle that they also share.
Soy voluntario, soy estudiante de la Facultad de Ingeniería de la Universidad Católica. Estoy aquí porque creo que lo que más podemos hacer es ahorita echar una mano a nuestros hermanos, ayudarnos, solidarizarnos, ser más empáticos con todo lo que está pasando. No me voy a quedar en la casa sentado viendo que la gente se está muriendo aquí. No me voy a quedar haciendo eso. Por eso vine hoy. Por eso estamos aquí.
Over the weekend, the indigenous people marched against austerity measures and again faced state violence and repression. As night fell, a ceasefire was supposed to take effect, but security forces continued to try to expel protesters from the city and to neutralize them with little respect for the shelters that had been declared peace zones.
Los policías están reprimiendo brutalmente. Este es un centro de acogida humanitaria y ha sido violentado.
En la Salesiana y en la Católica fuimos víctimas de cómo arrojaron bombas lacrimógenas, a pesar de que se había declarado que son zonas de paz. Y estábamos precisamente organizando el albergue con más de 1,000 personas de diferentes comunidades indígenas de todo el país. Y a pesar de eso, percibimos el olor. Entonces la gente, por supuesto, se intranquilizó, y comenzamos a diseñar un plan emergente de salida, porque ustedes sabrán que un coliseo tiene las salidas limitadas. Es un llamado al cumplimiento de los derechos humanos, respeten las zonas de paz y apoyen al pueblo ecuatoriano en su lucha por los derechos de toda la población.
As of October 13, Kanai denounces there has been 10 deaths, over 2,000 injured, over 1,000 people arrested, and 100 people missing. They also denounced cases of torture performed by police and army officials. Among the arrested, there are at least 13 journalists and 26 politicians. Also, at least 57 journalists were reportedly attacked by police and 9 media outlets closed. The leftist Latin American outlet Telesur was taken off the cable company's programming without any explanation. After 11 days of conflict, the main indigenous organizations and President Lenin Moreno agreed to participate in a dialogue with the mediation of the United Nations mission in Ecuador.
He pasado 13 días en la calle sin comer. Han muerto nuestros hermanos. Eso quiere decir que nuestro presidente nos manda atacar con hombres armados. Cuando nosotros hemos venido con una lucha pacífica, me duele en el alma cuando nuestros pequeños han tenido que entregar sus vidas ahogándose con bombas lacrimógenas. Que en su conciencia quede todos los hermanos caídos en esta lucha.
In his speech, Lenin Moreno again blamed former Ecuadorian President Rafael Correa for the crisis in the country, while indigenous representatives confronted him, demanding the resignation of his ministers of Interior and Defense, as well as the immediate drop of the IMF measures. After hours of negotiation, Moreno agreed to withdraw the neoliberal measures, known as Decree 883, but insisted on a joint commission to issue a new one on how to reduce the fuel subsidies. Some of the indigenous leaders were opposed to a new decree, and there is uncertainty on how much the IMF's prescriptions will actually be dropped. Popular and indigenous movement is divided between those who are already celebrating a victory and those who plan to remain alert and ready to go back to the protest until they see the new decree.